Good evening and welcome to our Good Friday service here. It is the Easter weekend, and for centuries the Christian church has marked these 3 days, often either by gathering on a Maundy Thursday or, in our case, here tonight on a Good Friday service. And much of the service tonight, I'm going to have some announcements to make after our time in communion. Most of the service will flow unannounced, but we're grateful. I'm really grateful to see you here tonight and glad that we can come and focus on the cross of Jesus Christ. Today, the carpenter's hands are nailed to a cross. Today, the King of Kings is crowned with thorns and wears the purple robe of mockery. Today, he sets us free, himself imprisoned on a tree. Today is Good Friday. Today is God's Friday. Our service this evening will trace the story of Christ's passion. And through scripture, silence, song, and growing darkness, we will remember the drama of Jesus' final hours. I pray we're able to set aside the busyness and the hurriedness and the chaos of our world tonight and focus intently on Jesus and his suffering and his death. And through all of this, the glory of the cross that becomes for us a tree of life. And as we begin this time, please join me in prayer. O Christ, who forsook no one but was forsaken by the Father, who committed no crime, yet was sentenced to death, we enter your presence in awe and adoration this evening. On this day, centuries ago, you could have saved your life, but you refused to betray the purpose for which you had come. And that love required you to shoulder a cross. And you summoned the strength to bear it. Today, O Christ, as we sing about the cross, teach us the meaning once again. How can it be that you, my God, should die for me? And on hearing this good news, may we cherish the cross and take it up and follow you. And we pray this in your name, Jesus. Amen. Hear these words from Isaiah 53. Familiar words often used around this time of year. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows, yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. In the wonder, and really ultimately the joy of this verse, please join me and stand as we sing together How Deep the Father's Love for Us. be seated. Having washed the disciples' feet, demonstrating what it means to love, what it means to serve one another, Jesus then shared the Passover meal with his disciples. Here we remember. Here we believe. Our redemption is by grace alone. And it would not be possible if Jesus had not died for our sin. While they were eating, Jesus took a piece of bread, said a blessing, broke it, and gave it to them with these words, "This is my body. It is broken for you. Do this to remember me." And later, Jesus took the cup, saying, "This cup is God's covenant, sealed with my blood. Drink from it, all of you, to remember me." Christ calls the bread his body and the cup his blood, or the new covenant in his blood. And in this moment, Christ teaches us that the bread and the wine nourish our temporal life, so too his crucified body and blood nourish our souls for everlasting life. We come to the table again this evening on this Good Friday. We come as those who wish to serve Jesus, but we must understand that we must be served first. Those who want to follow him must first be fed by Jesus. Those who would wash his feet must first let him make them clean. So come. Come, you who are hungry, you who are thirsty, those who long for the blessed life and for a world without end. For Jesus Christ invites us as guests at his table. And as Jesus said a prayer before the meal with his disciples, please pray with me. We praise you, Father, here on this wonderful night of worship, because we remember your promise to reconcile us to yourself. You have come among us in Jesus Christ, the eternal Word made flesh. We thank you, Jesus, for carrying the judgment on our sin. We thank you for your sacrifice to remove our guilt. We thank you that you walked out of the grave, Lord of life, conqueror of sin and death. We pray, Holy Spirit, you will renew our hearts, move us to faith, and lead us in the truth. We ask all of this in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray, saying together, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen." People of God, come to the table. Come, you who have much faith, and you who would like to have more. Come, you who have been to this table often, and you who have not been in a very long time. Come, for Christ invites us to meet him, to be in awe of God's grace. The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. bread of heaven. Thanks be to God. The cup of thanksgiving, for which we give thanks, is a sharing in the blood of Christ. The blood of Christ, the cup of our salvation. Thanks be to God. Please join me in prayer. Almighty God, here on this Good Friday, we've come to the table to be nourished by faith. As we remember tonight the true bread of heaven, your Son, Jesus, who gave his life as a ransom for us. Help us again this night as we not only receive the sacrament of his body and blood, but remember the work of the cross. Help us to be filled with hope, filled with faith, filled with love, now and forever. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. the remainder of our service this evening is taken from one of the early Christian services called Tenebrae. And that Tenebrae word is Latin. It means darkness or shadows. And one of the striking features is not only the dimness in the room, but we will be snuffing out candles throughout the liturgy, remembering in that way the coming of his death at the cross. And toward the end of the service, you'll note that the Christ candle will be removed from the sanctuary, but in time returned again. Its exit symbolizes that moment in which we remember the death of Jesus, but not the winning of evil. And the time the candle is brought back, it'll symbolize the anticipated triumph that we will celebrate on Easter Sunday morning. Well, the part of this service tonight, the rest of it will proceed pretty well without announcement. You follow along. We're blessed tonight to not only be able to listen to God's word, but to sing some songs and be blessed by some ministry of music as well. Our first reading this evening is found in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 26, the shadow of betrayal. Listen to the word of God. When evening came, Jesus was reclining at the table with the 12. And while they were eating, he said, "I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me." They were very sad, began to say to him one after the other, "Surely not I, Lord." And Jesus replied, "The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man will go just as it is written about him. But woe to the man who betrays the Son of Man. It would be better for him if he had not been born." Then Judas, the one who would betray him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." And Jesus answered, "Yes, it is you." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading of the gospel is found in Matthew 26, the shadow of the agony of the Spirit. Listen to the word of God. Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took Peter and the two sons of Zebedee along with him, and he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me." Going a little farther, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Could you men not keep watch with me for 1 hour?" He asked Peter, "Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the body is weak." He went a second time and prayed, "My Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done." When he came back, he found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. So he left them and went away once more and prayed a third time, saying the same thing. Then he returned to his disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour is here. The Son of Man is to be betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer." While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd armed with swords and spears sent from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. "The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him." Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. And Jesus replied, "Friend, do what you came for." And then the men stepped forward, seized Jesus, and arrested him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you. A reading of the gospel as found in the gospel of Mark, the shadow of desertion and denial. Listen to the word of God. Then everyone deserted him and fled. While Peter was below in the courtyard, one of the servant girls of the high priest came by. And when she saw Peter warming himself, she looked closely at him. "You also were with that Nazarene Jesus," she said. But he denied it. "I don't know or understand what you're talking about," he said, and went away into the entryway. And when the servant girl saw him there, she said again to those standing around, "This fellow is one of them." Again, he denied it. After a little while, those standing near said to Peter, "Surely you are one of them, for you are a Galilean." And he began to call down curses on himself as he swore to them, "I don't know this man that you're talking about." Immediately, the rooster crowed the second time. Then Peter remembered the word Jesus had spoken to him, "Before the rooster crows twice, you will disown me three times." And he broke down and he wept. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading of the gospel is found in Matthew 27, the shadow of accusation. Listen to the word of the Lord. Meanwhile, Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" "Yes, it is as you say," Jesus replied. When he was accused by the chief priests and the elders, he gave no answer. Then Pilate asked him, "Don't you hear the testimony of those they are bringing against you?" But Jesus made no reply, not even to a single charge, to the great amazement of the governor. Now it was the governor's custom at the feast to release a prisoner chosen by the crowd. At that time, they had a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when the crowd had gathered, Pilate asked them, "Which one do you want me to release to you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called Christ?" For he knew it was out of envy that they had handed Jesus over to him. "Which of the two do you want me to release to you?" asked the governor. "Barabbas," they answered. "What shall I do then with Jesus, who is called Christ?" Pilate asked. And they answered, "Crucify him." "Why? What crime has he committed?" asked Pilate. But they shouted all the louder, "Crucify him." When Pilate saw that he was getting nowhere, but that instead an uproar was starting, he took water and washed his hands in front of the crowd. "I am innocent of this man's blood," he said. "It is your responsibility." And the people answered, "Let his blood be on us and on our children." Then he released Barabbas to them, but he had Jesus flogged and handed him over to the crowd. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A reading from the Gospel of Matthew 27. The shadow of crucifixion and humiliation. Listen to the word of God. Then the governor's soldiers took Jesus to the praetorium and gathered the whole company of soldiers around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and then they twisted a crown of thorns and set it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand and knelt in front of him and mocked him. "Hail, King of the Jews," they said. They spit on him, and then they took the staff and struck him on the head again and again. And after they had mocked him, they took off the robe and put his clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him. As they were going, they met a man from Cyrene named Simon, and they forced him to carry the cross. They came to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. There they offered Jesus wine to drink mixed with gall, but after tasting it, he refused to drink it. When they had crucified him, they divided up his clothes by casting lots, and sitting down, they kept watch over him there. Above his head, they placed a written charge against him. "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Two robbers were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by hurled insults at him, shaking their heads and saying, "You are going to destroy the temple and build it in 3 days yourself? Save yourself. Come down from the cross if you are the Son of God." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you. A reading from the Gospel of Matthew again, this time again from chapter 27. The shadow of death. Listen to the word of the Lord. From the sixth hour until the ninth hour, darkness came over the land. About the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of those standing there heard this, they said, "He's calling to Elijah." Immediately, one of them ran and got a sponge. He filled it with wine vinegar, put it on a stick, and offered it to Jesus to drink. The rest said, "Now leave him alone. Let's see if Elijah comes to save him." And when Jesus had cried again in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split. The tombs broke open and the bodies of many holy people who had died were raised to life. They came out of the tombs, and after Jesus' resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many people. And when the centurion and those who were guarding Jesus saw the earthquake quake and all that had happened, they were terrified and exclaimed, "Surely he was the Son of God." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The reading of the gospel is found in John 19. the shadow of burial, listen to the word of God. Later, Joseph of Arimathea asked Pilate for the body of Jesus. Now, Joseph was a disciple of Jesus, but secretly, because he feared the Jews. With Pilate's permission, he came and took the body away. He was accompanied by Nicodemus, the man who earlier had visited Jesus at night. Nicodemus brought a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 75 pounds. Taking Jesus' body, the two of them wrapped it with the spices in strips of linen. This was in accordance with the Jewish burial customs. And at the place where Jesus was crucified, there was a garden. And in the garden, a new tomb in which no one had ever been laid. Because it was the Jewish day of preparation, and since the tomb was nearby, they laid Jesus there. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. invite you to stand. In the weight of a Good Friday service, the Christian church knows we are not a people without hope. Therefore, we don't grieve as those without hope. We cling to the one who we know, who we profess, rises again on the third day. And so it is good for us to close our service professing together these very words of faith as we find them in the Apostles' Creed. Please join me as we say together, I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. People of God, this is our faith. We cling to it, for we cling to the one who died on a cross for us. He was despised, but he was not defeated. The King of Jews would die, but through his death, all the families of the nations would worship him. Receive God's blessing as you go now from this place. May Jesus Christ, who for the sake of our disobedience became obedient to the Father, even to death on a cross, may he keep you and may he strengthen you. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and together God's people say, Amen. Amen.